Tonight we're getting our first look at the damage caused by the recent high winds, rough surf, and higher than average tides. Treasure Coast beaches took a real beating. John Zanitas is live in Fort Pierce with a closer look at that damage. John?
Todd, it looks more like a cliff than a beach out here right now. You can see how the water, the waves just came up and crashed up against the beach and carved out this drop off. I'm about 6'1", and it's just about as tall as I am, and it just goes as far as the eye can see. No reports of structural damage, but as you can see, the beach took quite a beating.
And it's Mother Nature, can't do anything about it.
Ray Benvenuti has been living here for 12 years.
And I'm on the beach every day fishing. And so I noticed the changes.
And he noticed a big change this morning.
I am very surprised by this. I knew it was going to be bad, but I didn't think it would be this bad.
High winds and big waves took out a big chunk of the beach.
This is as bad as any hurricane I've seen to be, believe it or not.
A few miles south on Waveland Beach, the tide was so high Wednesday morning, a lot of beachgoers turned around and headed back to the parking lot.
We were in the water when we got here, so this is... It's gone out a lot, the tide.
These ladies vacationing from New England decided to ride out the high tide, which came up all the way to the dunes.
The sun, we haven't seen it in a few days.
Mother Nature will bring the beaches back.
What happens is it all gets pulled out to the sandbars, and the smaller waves, when it calms down, will start pushing it back in.
Benvenuti is worried about how long that will take.
This is going to take a while for this to come back.
With St. Lucie County, they told me this is all up to the weather to determine how long it will be to naturally replenish this beach. As of right now, they're thinking it could be weeks, even months. For right now, I'll send it back to Chris and Mike in the studio.